today, I'm going to take you end to end of what the current Midland Trace Trail is. It's the current intersection over there is Indiana 32 and then Ditch Road. So this is the western end of the Midland Trace. I don't believe they have completed it, and there's sections that don't really connect that are actually the Midland Trace. So, but I'll show you as far as it is. It's from this section of Ditch Road all the way to Hague Rd on the eastern end. So. I'm on your left. Oh. Hello. So this is one of our first fairly nice days in, well, really nice days. February. We haven't really had a nice one since probably November or October. It's 60 degrees and pretty windy. I'm on your left. So there's a bunch of machine noise. This is currently where the trail crosses Spring Mill Road. Thank you. this intersection is Oak Bridge Road. This is the southern portion of the Monon. I do not think it doesn't say the Midland Trace goes that way. So I believe we'll go down this way to 169th Street, I think. So we follow Monon south to 169th Street. I'm not sure which road this is. Having his golden retriever help a little bit. I think that was a golden retriever. This is the intersection of the Monon and 169th Street, but we're going to go east. normally I would run left up to Westfield Boulevard and then across some of those trails. I don't think the West or the Midland Trace is actually defined for that. So what we're going to do is go straight ahead to the Natalie Wheeler Trail, which runs north-south. It's not very long. It runs to, I believe it's pretty much downtown Westfield at Union and 32. And then it runs all the way down to Cool Creek Park. So this right here is the Natalie Wheeler Trail. So this is where we join back up with the Midland Trace. This is Cherry Street. Thank you. on your left. This intersection is Cary Road, Midland Trace. This intersection is Gunther Boulevard. I'm on your left. This intersection is Gray Road. I'm going to go ahead and stop a minute and check this mirror. Thank you. had this nut mount or what have you that cracked. So I just took it out. The mirror seems to be doing fine, so it may not keep its tension, I guess, but it seems to be doing okay now. So this is a connector to Tulip Tree Drive. On your left. So that back there connected to Bruce Boulevard. This is an elementary school over here, Hazel Dell Elementary. Thank you. the intersection with Hazel Dell Road. It has some traffic stop buttons, so that's kind of nice when it's busy. It does get busy. One of the rare speed limit signs in Westfield, 15 miles per hour. I do really try to follow the speed limits on the trails and slow down when I'm around people. I think we have a responsibility for electric bike riders to be sort of ambassadors. That way we aren't as regulated, because it will be coming if we drive like jerks or idiots. So, and a lot of our bikes can go pretty fast. So, not saying a 50 mile an hour bike should be on the trails, but the more we act like idiots on the roads, even then they'll require registration, insurance. They may already require that in some states. Thank you. It's the intersection with Mill Creek Road. On your left. I'm on your left. I'm on your left. Thank you. This is the intersection with Willowview Road. contractor to, not sure, Al Jones Incorporated. Looks like folks that do small buses. Oh, you can pay attention. So up here is the current terminus of the Midland Trace. It's at the intersection of Indiana 32 and Hague Rd. So we are currently in Noblesville, Indiana. I'm on your left, guys.